you double your donkey. Sir, as it is written, fear not, your future. Behold, your king is coming, sitting on a donkey's coat.
And then he controls the ruckus. And those people are so loud, and look at all the mess they made. It's a huge mess.
But it's so exciting to see all those people and kids yelling for that guy on the donkey. They were throwing down their bush and palm branches for him to walk on.
Yeah, you know, it's almost like they thought he was going to be their king. Humans are so silly sometimes. A real king wouldn't come in on a donkey. He would fly. Yeah, that was so cloud kid. And then, bam, he'd be right there.
You're so right, Uncle Audius.
I know.
And you're very humble.
Yes, that I am. I have taught various classes on how you too can be humble. But just take a while, easy steps. Oh, that's not what she's saying, Peter. She has invented a new flossing device, which is environmentally friendly.
No. I am just excited to see all the people and the kids calling out, Hosanna! Hosanna!
Yeah, I heard that too. So when they said Hosanna, did someone named Anna leave for forgotten horse running, you know, like, Hosanna?
Remember your breathing exercises. Yeah, get the good air, After people turn on Jesus, after all the mean things he's done.
Well, I'm not sure how that will happen or when, but I know that God's word has never been wrong. It would be so sad to see that happen to him, but God always has a plan that is outside of what we can see or understand.
It just makes me feel bad, especially for all those little kids who are crying out Hosanna.
Oh yeah, those loud, noisy kids.
Well, don't forget that Jesus always wanted the little children to come to him. Why, I even heard Jesus say once, "Let the little children come to me, and do not forbid them, for of such is the kingdom of God." Assuredly, I say to you, whoever does not receive the kingdom of God as a little child will by no means enter it.
Even if those people and children didn't cry out, Uncle August, the watch would cry out.
Now, don't you too worry. It is just Rocky, my pet rock.
Oh, I just thought that thing about rock crying out was to make Jesus arrival sound special.
Yeah, when someone says, "You rock," you don't really think that they're a rock.
Nope, what he has said is true. Even we rocks are God's creation, and all creations are witness of his creator.
Yes, but we're talking about Jesus of Nazareth, who rode in on a donkey.
I know.
Yeah, that guy who has all the palm branches thrown at him?
Uh-huh, I know.
For half the size of your rock brain is preventing you from understanding.
Yes, we were talking about Jesus that was in Seal, and you were talking about the Creator.
I know. Jesus is God in human flesh, and thus he must also be the Creator walking amongst his creation.
Did you hear that? That was the sound of my mind being blown.
You know, rocks are best smart. They're just quiet most of the time.
I had no idea that Jesus was God in human flesh. So that means the Messiah is God clothed in the fabric of man.
That's what I said there to be. You know, those Romans are always big about conquering the enemies and displaying their victory and all, but Jesus' victory will be a spiritual victory over the power of death.
Oh, then it is true. Jesus really is a Messiah, and God is human flesh.
So many people have made up their own idea of who the Messiah would be, and if he would be all magical. Yep. And some even thought that just because the story of the coming Messiah was old, then it wouldn't happen. A lot of people doubted his coming. Now, all the doubters can believe.
But now we can rejoice, because we know the power of the Messiah as well. It is true.
There's a story going around, and started long ago. And everyone keeps telling it in places I know. And because my heart is weary, I really want to know. Is it true what they say? Because the story's gone, not me really knows.
Oh, yeah, and the smell of that donkey is easy to follow. I can't wait to see all the amazing things that he will do.
We should get going if we want to catch up to him. Hey, do you want me to carry you, Rocky?
I'm not wrong.
Okay, then. Talk to you more, Rocky. Let's go. Bye.